In this video, I will go over the process to create a WFX file from a Gaussian calculation. First, this step is necessary as the ChargeMob program uses natural orbitals to calculate different properties. A natural orbital contains an FI term, which represents the occupation number stored within the WFX file. To get the electron and spin density of a system, the natural orbital equation is already diagonalized, that is, there are no cross terms among orbitals. In turn, ChargeMob can get density-dependent properties such as net atomic charges, atomic spin moments, and bond orders. It can also perform orbital-dependent analysis to get the SPDFE populations and bond order component. To learn how to convert an already existent F-check to a WFX file, please watch our video on multi-WFN. In this example, a WFX file is going to be created for a spin non-polarized chlorous acid using density functional theory, DFT. First, open your ready-to-submit Gaussian.uaf input file in a text editor, and type in your job specification line output equals WFX. Now, create a blank line after the last text line and then copy the name of the file, paste it, and add the .wfx. After that, create another blank line and save the file. Then, I will copy a previously used batch file to the folder of the example. Make sure you open it and change the name of your input file to coincide with the one modified before. Also, pay attention to the extension. Change the name of the output log file too, and then save. In the cluster, change the transfer settings to text and drag the folder to the cluster. Submit the Gaussian job script to the batch queue. Refresh the directory, and when the WFX file appears, check for completion. Then, load the Gaussian module in order to convert the .check file output to a .fcheck text file. Refresh the directory and now delete the 4.7 and check binary files. Open the log file and check for normal termination and for convergence. This block of 4 converged only appears during a geometry optimization calculation to show the geometry has properly converged. For other kinds of calculations, such as single point calculations that compute the energy and electron density for a fixed geometry, this block of 4 converged does not appear. Open the WFX file. This file contains the system's geometry, its net charge, the spin up and spin down natural orbitals, the natural orbital occupancies, and orbital energies only for DFT and Hartree-Fock calculations. For this example, we see integers in the occupation numbers and non-zero digits for the energies. For spin non-polarized DFT calculations, the alpha and beta orbital spins are integrated in a single matrix, so the spin types appear as alpha and beta here. Transfer the output files to your local computer. Then, delete all the files, except the WFX, from your directory in the cluster. And prepare for ChargeMob submission. In this case, I will get the job_control and batch files from a previously run example. If you want more information on how to submit a ChargeMob job, go to our other videos. Change the input file in the job control. Check the batch file and submit the job. Now we consider a spin-polarized DFT example. Open the .uaf file and just as done in the previous example, type output equals WFX at the end of the line for the job specifications and copy the name of the file. Notice that now we have the basis set loaded in the input file. If desired, we could have used one of Gaussian's built-in basis sets instead. Just as in the last example, leave one blank line after the last line with characters and paste the name of the output file and the .wfx extension. Leave a blank line after that. Close the file and then create the batch submission file for this job. Change your input file to match the name of the .uaf file and .log file. Save it. go to the cluster, and with the text transfer setting selected, move the file to the cluster. Run the job. Hit refresh after some time, and when you see a .wfx file, check the status of the job submission. When the job is done, create the fcheck file. Note that since I had previously loaded the Gaussian module, I didn't have to load it again. Refresh the files in the cluster, and now you can delete the 4.7 and .check binary files. Check your job finished correctly and converged. Open the WFX file, and for this example, note the occupancies are still integers, and the orbital energies are included, as this was a DFT example. But note that now the spin types are separated as alpha, beta, and not together as alpha and beta, as in the last example. This is because the molecule is spin polarized, with a multiplicity of 2. Just as done last time, transfer the files and leave the WFX file ready for charge mold submission. Now, a spin-polarized CCSD example on barium chloride. Open your ready GAF file, and as this is a couple cluster example, we need to let Gaussian know that we want to use the current density matrix instead of the SCF density. For that, add the keyword density equals current to the job specifications. You have to include density equals current for correlated wave functions calculations like CCSD, CAS-SCF, SAC-CI, MP2, CISD, etc. But should omit density equals current for DFT and Hartree Fock calculations. The keyword density equals current tells Gaussian to generate the natural orbitals by diagonalizing the correlated first order density matrices. Also, the keyword pseudo equals read was included, because in this example, an effective core potential is replacing some of the core electrons of the heavy elements. Note, now I am letting Gaussian know that I want to use basis sets and pseudo potential files stored in separate files. Alternatively, you could use one of Gaussian's built-in basis functions or place a custom basis function directly into the GAF file as shown in the two prior examples. Add output equals WFX, leave a blank line after the last text line, and write the output name plus the WFX extension. Leave another blank space after that and save the file. Create the batch file. Transfer the folder to the cluster and run the job. When done, check the normal termination and convergence. Now, in the WFX file, the orbital occupancies are not integers. Fractionally occupied orbitals occur for various correlated wave function methods, such as Cobol clustered, MP2, configuration interaction, SAC-CI, etc. Since this is a spin-polarized example, the occupancies decrease to 0 for the alpha electrons, and then start again and decrease to 0 for the beta electrons. The orbital energies are now 0, because energies are not available for the coupled cluster natural orbitals. And just as expected, the orbital spin types are divided into alpha, beta. Generate the fcheck file and delete the binary files. Transfer the output to your local computer and leave the WFX in the folder to run the charge mold calculation. Now, we can see our CAS-SCF example. Open the GAF file and add density equals current. And now, note the pop equals NOAV keyword has been added in order to do a separate natural orbital analysis for the alpha and beta densities. Add output equals WFX. And after the last text line, add the output file name followed by .wfx. Leave a blank space after. Create the batch file. Transfer the file to the cluster and run the job. When the job is done, check the log file. Create the fcheck file. Open WFX file and notice we have mixed integer and fractional, as well as paired alpha and beta spin types due to the nature of a CASSEF calculation. Again, for correlated wave functions, the orbital energies are printed as zero to indicate they are not available. Delete the binary files and transfer the rest to your local computer. For more videos and tutorials, visit our channel. We thank the NSF Career Award for making this video possible.